next speaker, Engineer Tariq Mahmood Saab. He will share a few words with us, inshallah. Engineer Tariq Mahmood Saab from Birmingham.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Nahmaduhu wa nusalli ala Rasulihi al-Kareem. In a very few minutes, I would make a few remarks. Basically, I would like to call you to help me and help this conference and all the efforts in this very field. That is that we have to concentrate and attract those who are going to the hellfire. We know for sure that anybody who does not seek refuge in the fold of Islam and does not accept Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam as last of the messenger and apostles, there is no success for them. If we want to save those souls from the corner of hellfire, we have to make some effort. I'm pointing your attention towards the Qadiani youth. We can understand that their elders, why did they leave the fold of Islam? That was a very difficult time. The power and the might of the British Raj got at its top. At that time, there were many fitnas coming. There were worldly attractions. There were reasons we can understand why Qadiani's fitna. Why did it appear? Why did it surface? Why did Mirza Ghulam Ahmad start all this? Because the government at that time wanted to find differences in Muslims and divide them in order to strengthen their own government and their own control, not only on India and Pakistan, but over the whole world. At that time, not only Mirza Ghulam Ahmad proclaimed to be a messiah and then a messenger and so on, but at the same time, in South America, in Africa, there were many other people who also made similar claims. So we can understand why did they go astray. Mirza Ghulam Muhammad, for example, initially he tried, at the suggestion of their masters, to be messiah, and then he advanced, and then he tried to claim to be a messenger, and then he even went as far as claiming that he is, astaghfirullah al-azim, he is complimentary Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, astaghfirullah al-azim. And then, the last 10 years of his life, he tried to retract that, but without clearly saying that he was wrong, he is false, and the reasons why he went this far, and why did he try to do what he did for the sake of his masters. He also tried to walk out of it by claiming that if people are, that I'm not claiming to be a messenger of Allah in the same sense as the previous messengers were, but I am shadow of the messengers, that I am a completion of the messengers, and so on. And he even writes in one of his books that if my claim to apostlehood offends Muslims, then please accept that word to be crossed out. There is clear words ke aap mujhe kata hua nabi samajh lein. Kata hua nabi, that I have been crossed out, and we say we agree. We disagree with all your message, but we agree with this line that you are crossed out. But now the problem is that our heart and our efforts should be concentrating on if we can save their youth. Their youth are not in the same predicament. They are not under that colonial rule that their forefathers were. So my appeal is that all Qadiani youth, please try to concentrate and think about the circumstances under which your leader came to claim the leadership. Those were special circumstances. He claimed to be Messiah because Muslims at that time were oppressed. They wanted a reliever. They wanted their difficulties and their slavery to go away, break away from all these difficult circumstances. They were being oppressed. So Mirza Ghulam Ahmad said that I am the Messiah. If you come to my fold, then all these difficulties will go away. Christianity will finish. The pig and the swine fog will disappear. All Christians will come to the fold of Islam and they will denounce the cross and they will denounce the pig. That's the claim he made. He said, times of peace and tranquility will return. These are the claims he made. O Qadiani youth, let's take the message to them. Please think, you were offered success by this false prophet of yours. You were promised success and peace and tranquility. End of Christianity. Did that happen? No, it did not happen in the lifetime of Mirza Ghulam Ahmad. Okay, then they started this. They created their own creed and their own faith parallel to Islam. That is, they started to having caliphs. Like we have Khulafa after the Prophet Muhammad Rasulullah, they also tried to follow the same route. So this royal family of theirs, that is the descendants of Ghulam Ahmad Qadiani, his sons and his grandsons and so on, it's a royal family. They have all the taxes collected and they live a different life from ordinary Qadianis. Let's appeal to the Qadiani youth, think about it, that when Mirza failed, they tried to deceive you second time. That is, they said, okay, those promises did not come true in the life of Mirza Ghulam Muhammad, but these will come true during the time of Khilafah. Now, his sons went one after another, their grandsons went one after another, and now Mirza Masroor is making the same false promises. How long are you going to be deceived? 100 years have gone past. These promises will never come true. If Qadianis, as they claim to be, on the right path, and they claim that we Muslims are on the wrong path, you were promised that the success from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to you to help you. What's happened? Muslims are all united and Qadianis are facing nothing but misery and disgrace. Who is on the side of Qadianis? Non-Muslims. Like America will help them, like United Kingdom will help them, like Germany will help them. But they are, so one way of recognizing somebody is, who is their friend? Oh, Qadiani youth, think about it. Your supporters are those who are arch enemies of Muslims. How long are you going to be deceived in this way? Please come to the fold of Islam. Your forefathers left Muslims in the hope that Mirza's promises might save them. Please think about it. It is difficult to accept that they were wrong, but the span of time has shown that they were wrong. Please come back to the fold of Islam. Please think about eternal success. What is eternal success? What is help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When help comes to messengers, we have examples in the Quran. When help came to Musa alayhi salam, he took his community through the sea and the sea opened for them. That is help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Pharaoh wanted to follow them and he was destroyed. This is help from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Similarly, Nuh alayhi salatu wasalam, when all people rejected him, his people rejected him, then the storm came. And what is success, what is help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That the ark, in ark they were safe, they were saved. And the enemies of the Messenger of Allah were destroyed. This is success of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. O Qadiani youth, let's go to them and ask them, O Qadiani youth, please think about it. Qadiani youth, please think about it. Do not destroy yourself. Come to realize effects. Look, the reality and the truth is staring you in the eyes. The promises you were made, the promises that were given to you by your Messiah, so-called Messiah, were all lies, but nothing else. It brought to you and to the Muslim Ummah nothing but misery. And the situation went from bad to worse. Please think about it. Do not throw your lives after the deception which enveloped your ancestors. If you come back to the fold of Islam, if somebody, you know, a child goes out of the house, this has disagreement with the family, and then he goes out in the morning, But he comes back in the evening. We don't say that you're not from amongst us. We accept him with open arms. O Qadiani youth, we will accept you with open arms. Please come back to the fold of Islam. And let us pray for the eternal success. Let us forgive and disassociate ourselves from the lies of Mirza Qadiani and his descendants and his royal family. And let us accept the message of Muhammad Rasulullah, who was the last of the messengers. There are no more messengers to come and be appointed after that. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to discharge our duty, that is not only to be on the right path, but also save those who are on the corner of hellfire. أقول قولي هذا أستغفر الله لكم ولسائر المسلمين.